Welcome back to Sports Chat.
503.
Ooh, I like it.
Yeah.
Okay, this one goes out to all those people out there, Memorial Day weekend, who set up the barbecue weeks in advance, set a date, get the place ready in the park, just to have it rain on the freaking barbecue. Had my kid's birthday party last year in the middle of June. The one day it rained during the summer was on that day.
And it rained, man.
And it rained. It just didn't stop. Yeah. The barbecue became a sense of heat, and it became like a hobo stove. People were freaking rubbing their hands over the top of the stove. So this one goes out to all you guys who have those barbecues that end up in the rain. Okay.
Soggy hot dog.
Exactly. Soggy hot dog. Oh, yeah. This week we had the second perfect game in 20 days. And this is the first time I've heard that they've been back-to-back in the same season. The 20th perfect game in baseball history.
Yeah.
Is throwing a perfect game the hardest thing to do in sports? In a one game, you come out for one day. You play one game. Like, I was thinking maybe to get some sort of, like, you know, quintuple dribble, quintuple double or something.
No,
you know, like a, instead of a quadruple double, like a quintuple double or something, like five.
Yeah,
like
get
like 10 blocks, that's 10 assists.
Or about like scoring 100 in a game.
Well, but that's I was thinking that.
Yeah.
But then I thought, well, you know, I mean, maybe scoring over 80.
Yeah.
Because you got to have something where it's like, I mean, yeah, scoring 100, it's never going to happen. That day that Wilt scored 100, other guys scored like 20.
Is that right?
It wasn't like just Wilt. Yeah, like.
And it's good that, you know, it's just one day, because I'd say probably like Tour de France or something like that.
Yeah, those stages.
Yeah,
like, you know,
multiple
days. Yeah, the Triple Crown or something.
Yeah,
they're doing all that kind of stuff.
One day.
It depends on everybody else.
You've got one game.
You come out. You play one thing. Is it a guy came out, and I heard a guy came out and shot a 24-9.
Wow.
Or something like that. I think it was 24 or 20.
Really?
25 or 24.
Wow. 36, huh? Wow.
Yeah. And so, I mean, just, you know, like, I was just thinking, you know, because these perfect games, it just seems weird to me that there wouldn't be two perfect games in one season.
Yeah,
I mean,
I'd say perfect game. Yeah, because there's so
everything
many,
has to go right.
So many variables that don't even rely, like, you know, errors.
Yeah.
You know, pass balls.
Even the ump.
Yeah.
Even the ump, give it screwing you on one third strike that you should have had.
Yeah, yeah,
but a lot
exactly.
of these guys, when they go these perfect games,
no
they don't
ball.
Even go into the third ball.
Never
they don't even get no.
Wow.
They like don't. I remember. I think it was David Cohn who had a perfect game and didn't get to the third ball.
Wow. What about you?
Had ball one, ball two, every count.
Never got to. What about you? You think it's the toughest thing, sport thing to do when?
I was originally thinking outside the box and trying to go into all different levels. I was trying to go into the idea of what would it mean in football. Like, what would this look like? Would this look like, you know, 300 yards in a game,
like
rushing?
How many yards would you have to run or throw for?
I mean, would it look like touchdowns?
Yeah, you have to
would
be
it
like
look like
10 touchdowns or something?
Would it look like, you know, kickoff returns or whatever? You know, what would that look like in football?
Yeah.
And I couldn't even come up with one. I couldn't even come up with it. And then I was thinking, okay, well, what about basketball? Then I thought Wilt. I thought of Kobe with the 80.
Yeah.
What do you have, 81, 82, something like that?
Triple doubles, quadruple
doubles. The triple double, then like a quadruple double where you add like steals to it or something.
Yeah.
You add another sort of element or, you know, rebounding or blocks or something.
Mm.
I don't know, man. I think that there is so many different variables throwing a perfect game. 27 up, 27 down.
Yeah.
Sit every single one of those guys down is so hard to me.
Yeah, yeah, no walks. I mean,
I could also see it as like being some sort of a thing where like a tennis match where it's just like straight sets, no errors.
Yeah.
But that happens.
I still see that.
I mean,
often.
Yeah, straight sets
I was
and
thinking
no
football maybe like you catch one,
run
touch,
for one,
catch
throw
one,
for
run
one.
For one, throw for one.
But see, that's kind of like a cycle type of a thing. And
yeah,
that's
what
I was also
true.
Thinking. I was also thinking, okay, do you want to hit for the cycle?
Yeah.
But with football, I think it would have to be, I mean, for me, if you, you know, I don't know.
Hitting 10 grand slams in the same inning.
I know, exactly.
It's like,
like, I mean, that's, to me, it's just, a perfect game says consistency more than it says explosion.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, hitting four home runs in the same game.
Yeah.
You know, that was something I also thought of. Like, every time you came up to bat, you bombed.
You went yard, yeah.
And it was a consistency that it was, like, every time. So, it was, like, in the golf thing, if you hit, like, a 23 or a 25 or a 26 or something like that, that every single time, you never had par.
Yeah.
You always had an eagle or always had bird or always had a double eagle or, you know, or something.
And you guys out there, write in with your ideas about what you think it could be. Give us some
suggestions.
Because, like, and we don't want to hear, like, I was saying, like, yeah, if you hit 1,500 grand slams in the same at bat, blah, blah. I mean, like, realistic stuff where it's, you know, it's maybe been done once or a handful of times.
You could never do it in NASCAR because what's a one track, you know, how many laps could you, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like there's nothing lead for, the race for the whole race. Right. And
there's nothing for...
And plus, who gives a shit about car,
right,
like, racing?
Right.
It's like saying, I got the hacky sack going, and I didn't stop for 10 minutes.
Exactly. So. Let's do this one real quick since we're on this level. All right,
buddy.
Maybe
you should go back out and kick the hacky sack some more.
Exactly. Is NASCAR a sport?
Yeah.
It's a sport. It's a why? Because there's a team.
Yeah.
Hand-eye coordination.
Yeah, hand-eye coordination. You got to...
But is the car part of the athlete? Like, is the athlete the driver and the car?
Yeah, the driver's an athlete because he has to know how to drive the car,
right,
and manipulate it. And,
like a jockey?
Yeah, kind of like that, yeah. And, like, there's like endurance and...
So a jockey is riding a horse is a sport.
Yeah.
People say golf isn't a sport. I would say golf's a sport.
I'd say golf's a sport, yeah. I mean, there's same thing, like experience
endurance
plays a part. Yeah, endurance, preparation.
Consistency.
Yeah, exactly.
How about bowling?
See, that's, yeah, you're getting a little bit more out there at bowling, because...
Bowling, like, walks a fine line, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does, because, I mean, first of all, like, really, who cares? But second of all...
If they take, like, the adult group home to the bowling alley to play the same game that, like, league night...
Yeah, exactly. If someone,
the same game,
yeah,
you know?
So, and plus, it's like, you know, the...
Yeah,
the
wheelchair basketball, but, you know...
You know, I guess golfers aren't the best example, but, like, you look at a professional bowler... And it doesn't scream athlete to you, you know? It screams, I'm stopping at...
Mini-Mart.
I'm stopping at 7-Eleven to get those nachos on the way home.
Mini-Mart. You
know? Yeah, exactly.
JoJo's.
How many breakfast whatevers can I buy with $10?
Right? Oh, man.
But, yeah, bowling, yeah, I don't know. Yeah,
how about pool?
Pool? No. I refuse to give it to pool. No, it's nothing. No.
Oh, okay, curling.
Curling... No, it's, well...
It's in the Olympics.
I know, it's sad, isn't it? Square dancing? Is that a sport? No, that's in the Olympics.
Square dancing?
Square dancing, I know.
No way.
Swear, hand to whatever...
Who the hell else square dances besides country Western Americans?
Well, apparently there's enough country Western Americans to...
Maybe it came from Germany.
Auf deine Deutschlande, yeah, ein bisschen... Maybe, but
I'm just saying, man, if you want to go with saying that golf isn't a sport, why can't people play it?
Yeah, you know, that's a great,
like,
reason to
people,
see if it's a sport or
people
not.
People can bowl.
Yeah.
Like, people can throw the ball.
Oh, yeah.
My kid can throw the thing down the bowling aisle.
Yeah, Monty Burns can
roll it on down, but... They can't golf.
Yeah, exactly. I mean...
They can't go out and hit a baseball.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
They can't
thing.
Catch a football. Run... Catch, run.
Yeah.
Not
yeah.
just like catch one if I threw it to you. Like
yeah.
run and catch and then run some
yeah.
more.
Here's a good one. Is shooting a sport? Target shooting.
Again, is the gun part of the athlete? You know, because to me, shooting would be, okay, I like the shooting where it's on the skis, the cross country.
Uh-huh, ski shooting. Yeah.
Yes, because that's an endurance thing. It's a consistency. Can I keep hitting the target? Can I keep doing this as I go through? Just going to the range and just doing this and firing? No.
No. I agree.
But with the skis, out in the elements.
Yeah, there are variations that could make it a sport. Like, put skis on.
Run around,
around
in
track.
Circles.
Yeah.
Do this one with the butt of a gun. And then... Shoot at clay pigeons.
On an ice rink.
Then shoot at clay pigeons.
Yeah.
And then just go, watch out. Don't go Dick Cheney on your neighbor. Okay. Sports Chat 503. Peace. Good. Be good.